Now let us discuss a technique of Vedic maths, that is finding square of a two digit number using Anurupiana method. Vedic maths is basically a way provides us various techniques so that we can perform calculations in a faster way. As you know that in a competitive exams the time is always short, and if we use these techniques a lot of time will be saved, so we will be able to solve more questions in the time given to us, and so we have a better chance to crack a competition. So I would suggest you to master these techniques. Only then you will be able to use these techniques in a competitive exam. And to master these techniques, the only way is to give regular tests. So you can subscribe, you can register on our portal, and you can give tests and practice yourself so that whenever you are sitting in a competitive exam, you will be able to solve the questions in a faster way. So now I am trying to use the technique of Anurupiana method to find the square of a two digit number. So let us take the case of a two digit number as 34. So I take 34 as a number, it is a two digit number, and I am finding the square of this number using Anurupiana method. In this, I will take the digit at the tens place as x and the digit at the ones place as y. So here x will be 3 and y will be 4. So the first step is to find the value of x and y. Here I have taken x as 3 and y as 4 because the digit at the tens place is considered as x and the digit at the ones place is considered as y. So the next step is to find the square of y, that is y square. Now y square is, y is 4, so square of 4 is 16. Now when I get 16, it is a two digit number, I will take the digit at the unit place and prefix it in the answer. So we prefix 6 in the answer and 1 is considered as carry. So now this 6 has been prefixed in the answer and 1 is the carry. In the next step, I will multiply x with y and then double the result. That means 2 into x into y. So basically 2 into x into y. Now x is 3 and y is 4. So 2 into 3 into 4. Now 2 into 3 is 6. 6 into 4 is 24. So I get 24. And I have a previous carry. The carry was 1. So I add that carry to this. So the result becomes 25. So you can see that in this step I have multiplied x with y, then I have doubled the result, and then I also added the carry to it. So 2 into 3 into 4 is 24, and 1, that was the carry of the previous step, has been added. So 24 plus 1 is 25. Now when I get 25, I will take the digit at the unit place, that is 5, and I will prefix in the answer. So answer becomes 5, 6, and 2 is the carry. In the next step, I will find the square of x, that is x square. Now x is 3, so square of 3 will be 9. I will add the carry is 2, so 2 is added to it, and I get 11. This 11 is prefixed in the answer, so answer becomes 1, 1, 5, 6. So you can see that in just simple steps, I have found the square of a two digit number. So basically I would now sum up the concept. Basically what I have taken, I have considered a two digit number as 34. The digit at the tens place is considered as x and the digit at the ones place is considered as y. So the digit is, x is 3, now y is 4. In the first step, I have found the square of y, that is y square. Y square is basically 4 square and I get 16. Now I will, as 16 is a 2 digit number, so I have prefixed 6 in the answer and 1 is considered as carry. In the next step, I have multiplied x with y and I have doubled the result. So 2 into x into y, I get 24, and then I will add the carry. The carry was 1, which is added. So 24 plus 1 will become 25. Now from 25, 5 is prefixed in the answer and 2 is considered as carry. So answer becomes 5, 6 and the carry is 2. In the last step, I have founded the square of x, that is square of 3, that is 3 square is 9. I have added the carry, that was 2. 9 plus 2 is 11. So 11 has been prefixed in the answer. So answer becomes 1, 1, 5, 6. So you can see that I have found this square of a two-digit number in a very faster way. So if I use this technique in the competitive exam, a lot of time will be saved, because whenever we are in a competitive exam, we face a lot of questions in which we are supposed to find the square of any number, because whenever we are solving, there are many situations in which the squares are to be used, and if we use the normal method of finding the square, a lot of time will be used in calculating in that calculation, and hence most of the time will be wasted. So, but if we use these techniques, we will be able to save that time, and that time can be used to solve the other questions. So we will be having a better chance to crack the competition as compared to the other people sitting in the examination. So I would suggest you to master these techniques. Only then you will be able to use these techniques on that day.